Hello, welcome back to Let's Play King's Quest III. To Heir is human. Well, the wizard is gone, and we can look around the countryside a bit.
The world beyond the only life you've known begins here. An eagle sits in its nest, tilting its head as it eyes you warily. The precarious path winds around Manannan's mountain. Watch your step. Manannan's mountain dominates the sky. Manannan, an eagle sits in its nest.
Speaketh?
As you speak, the eagle shifts defensively. It doesn't trust you.
It's not me you have to worry about.
Think it'll let you pat it? Want to bet your hand? Think it'll... It's solid, but it'll give way if you go the wrong way. There's an easier way, and you're standing on it.
Okay. Well, the best way is to go little by little here. Okay. Can I stand on the edge here? Maybe reach this.
You've been living on this mountain too long already. Manannan's mountain dominates the sky.
Okay.
The land of Ludor spreads before you, promising a world of opportunity. The precarious path winds around Manannan's mountain. Watch your step. Manannan's mountain.
Okay, so... That's gonna be interesting when it turns yellow and trying to get through this mountain pass without falling off. And getting back in time.
The lone mountain rises from the forest to a cloud-encircled peak. A lone mountain rises sharply. A treacherous path winds its way to the peak. The winding path leads steeply up the mountain. It is difficult to see your house from here. Big, immovable lumps of stone, otherwise known as boulders. A lone mountain. A few trees grow around the base of the mountain. If you want a better vantage point, take a hike back where you came from. It's impossible to scale this mountain. Try the path. A little levitation might be easy for some, but care and realization saves a stitch in your tum.
There's a stitch in my tum. Alright, so far so good anyway. Let's see what's down here.
These two are certainly unsavory rogues. They look like they'd rob you blind.
Random. I guess they're random. Okay.
The path is well trodden. And the soft grass soothes your aching feet. Manannan's mountain sits to the north, a mound of overrated sediment.
Overrated.
A little cottage lies to the south as you stand between the desert and the port town. The many beautiful trees and bushes bring a sense of peace to this forest. The lone mountain rises from the forest to a cloud-encircled peak. Large rocks are common near mountains. The bushes would not conceal you, nor would trees reward your climb. If you could, what would you do with them? The grass serves its purpose best when left underfoot.
Okay, so there's a cottage this way. Hi. Who or what are you?
The lady of the house is tending the garden.
Whoa.
Maybe not. Hello. Sorry.
Okay.
What a beautiful garden, you think? The residents must take great care of it. Dew has formed on the petals from the night before. This is the door to the Behr's house.
The Behr's house?
This quaint little cottage is home to the Behrs. Some large rocks lay near the house and garden. A cottage sits near the southern edge of... This quaint little cottage is home to the Behrs.
Okay. See what happens now.
Scram!
Huh?
Scram!
I don't want to scram. Let's look through the window.
There's now a handprint on the pane. It would be better to use the door.
I can't use the door. They won't want me there.
They're not as useful as you imagine. You don't live here. Best not draw attention to yourself. This quaint little cottage is...
home to the Behrs. I got that.
Mama Behr growls at you as you near the flower bed. Better stay away from it. And her.
Oh boy, bees.
A swarm of busy bees buzz around their hive. This is the southwestern corner of the forest. You see a small cottage to the east and the desert to the west. Several bushes and small trees grow in this part of Ludor. A small cactus grows near the edge of the desert. Several bushes and a scrawny tree grows on the desert border. It's just an ordinary rock. Several bushes. You'd probably break it. It's too heavy to move. Very bad idea. Nothing hidden in there. That would be inviting trouble.
Yeah. Oh, crap. No!
After recovering from a whack on the head at the hands of the bandits, you stand unsteadily. Taking stock of your holdings, you discover that all of your possessions have been stolen.
All my possessions have been stolen. What did I have? What did they steal? Stole my knife. Can I get by without the knife? She's not there anymore.
There is no answer.
Interesting. Okay.
You are in the charming, cozy home of the three Behrs.
Three Behrs, and there's the...
The wooden chair is very large and solidly built.
Yes, baby Behr's chair.
The cute little chair looks sturdily built. The medium-sized chair looks soft and comfortable. Cheery flames crackle in the fireplace. The Behrs must feel the cold. You are in the charming, homely bunch, aren't they? Outside, you see the forest. There are bowls of porridge on the table, a far cry from the fish, honey, and berries you were expecting. A rustic wooden stairway leads to the second floor. Homely bunch. Cheery flame. Cheery. Cheery. Cheery flame. Cheery.
Cheery flames.
A rustic. Homely bunch. This chair feels just right.
Okay. Oops.
You feel very small and uncomfortable in this big chair. This chair is much too hard. You sink too deeply in the overstuffed chair. This chair is much too soft. There is only a splintered pile of wood that was once a small chair.
Fix it.
There is only a... Just right. So you take it with you. You taste the porridge and decide that this bowl of porridge is too hot. You taste the porridge and decide that this bowl of porridge is too cold. The warm porridge is in a pretty blue ceramic bowl. Its aroma wafts up to and tantalizes your nose.
They took my mixing bowl also. Stinkers.
You don't feel like sitting down and taking a bite. Maybe later.
Up.
You are in the Behr family's cozy bedroom, three beds share with a chest of drawers. You sincerely hope that head isn't real. After all, what species would hunt its own?
They're cannibals.
You are in the Behr... A dresser sits in the corner of the room. You are in the... You closely examine the contents of the drawer.
Okay.
You can see a very ornate pincushion in the bottom of the drawer. Something tells you it belongs to Mama Behr. This drawer is filled with various implements for sewing. It must belong to Mama Behr. This drawer is... There is a spool of black thread in the drawer. There is a little silver sewing thimble here. A small green bottle rests in the bottom of the drawer. A small blue... As handy as a small bottle may be in other games, you see no use for it in this one. As handy as a small... Your clothes may be in need of repair, but you hardly have the time to worry about such things. You pick up the thimble.
Something I'm not supposed to have, okay.
The little thimble is fashioned of bright, gleaming silver.
Why am I not supposed to have a thimble?
You place the thimble on your finger. It's made for bigger fingers than yours, though. Your clothes may be in need. Your there is nothing. There is. This is a big old bed. It must be Papa Behr's. This looks like a nice soft bed. Maybe it's Mama Behr's. This bed looks just the right size for you.
Let's try the others. What we're supposed to do.
You flop onto the biggest bed. This bed is much too hard.
Now if I fall asleep, the wizard will come.
You jump onto the medium-sized bed and sink deep into its fluffy depths.
But... Since they stole my knife and mixing bowl anyway...
This bed is much too soft.
I don't mind having to restore at this point. That bed is just right.
You lie upon the smallest bed and snuggle down into the pillow. This bed is just right. You've fallen asleep.
Yep, great. I figured that was what would happen.
Oh no, Papa Behr has found you sleeping in Baby Behr's bed. You're in for it now.
Scram! Oh. Can you carry me? I'm sleeping.
Keep out of our house, human!
Damn. So, I still have these special things. I think I should go back and hire the symbol. It's been a while, so the wizard's gonna come back eventually. I don't know if I can fall off over here. I'll be more careful on the other screens. I'm sure there's something we have to do with that bird. So I can have the bowl of porridge, but not the symbol. Safely hidden.
You don't feel like sitting down and taking a bite. Maybe later.
Okay. Now I'm gonna save here. Interesting ansimal. There might be another item that was also removed, but I can't remember. The hand mirror? Maybe the hand mirror. Well, the hand mirror is a wizard item, right? Alright, let's go sleep. So actually I had quite a bit of time left.
I am hungry. Prepare me a meal at once.
Have your food, stinker. Actually, this is the end of the food. Do you kill me once the food runs out?
Manannan is impatient.
Poison the food, poison the food. What am I doing?
You take a moment's respite at the table next to your master.
I didn't want to do that.
The wizard is not amused by your actions.
Impertinence. I'll teach you some manners,
I just
William.
Clicked on the grapes.
You obviously don't lack energy. Let me help you blow off some steam.
YMCA. Wow, doing the sit-ups now. Yeah, what happened? The grapes aren't there anymore. Can't feed him anything now. I think that's something that, you know, would have happened no matter what. Hi.
I am going to lie down for a rest. Do not disturb me.
I surely will not. Whoops!
Watch your step.
Nah. Alright. I'm gonna restore from another save. Yeah, they took my bowl. Those are the two things they took. Knife and the bowl. These three items I was left with. So, I might need those items, so I don't want to get myself into a dead end. Do the Behr thing over again. I'll skip it. You guys don't have to watch it twice. Okay, this time I've gotten the items without.
These two are certainly unsafe.
Go! Like I was saying, I've gotten the... I took the thimble, and I didn't sleep in the bed.
Hurry along there, Mildred.
Yes, George?
Mama! My button's not done up!
Button? Haven't you taught him anything, Mildred?
It's a bit difficult for him, George.
Shall I follow him?
The forest grass gives way to a coarser coastal green. You're standing on a bluff overlooking the ocean. There's a village to the north. Offshore elements have affected the tree's growth. You look out over the vast blue-gray ocean. You wonder about its many lands, and feel ever more eager to depart this one. The mistletoe hangs from the branches of the tree. There are few dried sprigs mingled with the green mistletoe.
All right, I got some mistletoe.
You search among the hanging mistletoe until you find a sprig that has dried. You break it off and carry it with you.
I'm not allowed to have mistletoe either. Well, I guess that's proof that...
The dried sprig of mistletoe is a thick, grayish-green with remnants of little berries still attached. It is not a pretty plant.
That he catches me with these things is proof that I've been outside, because I guess he doesn't have a thimble, and where would I get mistletoe from?
There's nobody around whom you feel like kissing. The trees are smaller nearer the coast. Climbing these would serve no purpose. The grass best serves its purpose when left where it is. You stretch out your hands and imagine you are a bird.
Someday I'll fly away.
Aha.
You could use the sea to drown, but that isn't one of your priorities. You see a small seaside village up the coast to the north. Smoke rises lazily from chimneys, mingling with the ocean air.
Okay. We have a general store and a tavern.
The pier is made of rough but sturdy timber.
I didn't make it to any town in the first game when I used to play, no way.
The store sits on the south side of the pier. The tavern rests on the north side of the pier. You can see more town buildings further to the north. The store, it doesn't look interesting. It's a massive anchor. Perhaps it got left behind. A discarded fishing net lies on the ground. It has been here so long that grass has begun to grow over it.
I don't suppose we can get these huge things.
Leave the fishing to those in the know. The old rusted anchor is much too heavy to move. A sign above the store reads, General Store.
A sign above the tavern reads, Tavern.
A battered sign reads, Tavern.
We'll look through the little porthole.
You peer into the window, but cannot make out the dim interior. You peer in.
Alright, let's just go in. If we can, okay.
Good day to you, young man. What can I do for you?
Save me from a wizard.
The store provides supplies enough to meet the needs of the village. A friendly storekeeper bustles busily behind the counter. The short, balding storekeeper seems an amiable fellow. The shelves are stocked with many useful items, such as leather pouches, salt, fish oil, and lard. The counter is for conducting transactions.
Mm-hmm.
The door is open. Outside, you see the village and the ocean. The store provides supplies enough to meet the needs of the village. A friendly store. A content, hairy dog sits on the floor of the store. Its name tag reads, Hank.
Hank.
The store provides...
I've got some dusting to do. Let me know if you need anything.
Sure. I know all about dusting, believe me.
You pat the hairy dog and are rewarded with a handful of malted hair.
Oh, I got dog hair. Hair of the dog.
The wad of dog hair is dirty white and brown. The dog fur feels very coarse to the touch. As you pet him, Hank licks your hand and thumps his tail in appreciation. You speak to the dog in a soothing voice, and his ears perk up.
Go ahead and pet him. Hank loves attention.
I've been doing that. Woof. Pet him again.
As you pet him, Hank, if you want it, pay for it. He might not appreciate that. If you... Tis better to purchase than to purloin. Tis better to... Not unless you want singed hands. As it is chilly so close to the ocean, the wood stove is hard at work heating the little store.
Alright, I'll finally talk to this guy.
Just a moment. Now, what can I do for you?
Greetings. What have you for sale?
I have many an item that might interest you. For instance, you might wish to purchase a leather pouch, very suitable for carrying things in, as you might expect.
Indeed. Anything else?
I have numerous consumables that you may wish to acquire. Take a look at the shelf behind me. See if there's anything you would like.
The storekeeper wouldn't like you jumping on the counter.
I can't talk to him anymore. Give me a second.
He might...
Just a moment.
Yeah, with the speech icon was coming up.
What can I do for you?
Tell me, good storekeep. What news is there of the outside world?
Oh, I'm afraid I don't keep up much with current events. I have my own concerns, what with my work and family. I don't need any more from anywhere else spoiling my day.
In that case, anything new happening around here?
Around Lunor? 'Tis the same old town as it has always been. Ships come in, ships go out. People come in, people go out. Money comes in, and I'd prefer not to think on the next part.
If you don't mind my asking, how many in your family?
I have about 6 children.
About?
About. Aren't you sure?
I am but the breadwinner of my household. I spend most of my day, each day, tending my shop. If my dearest says that I have 6 children, then who am I to argue with her?
How long have you been married?
10 years.
Happily?
The first marriage was an enjoyable time. The second marriage helped to pass the time. The third was a total waste of time.
And now?
I have not the desire to spoil my present union with the binds of legal matrimony. Why ruin a perfectly good relationship?
Okay, turn off on marriage.
What do you know about Manannan?
The shopkeeper appears a little uncomfortable at the mention of the wizard's name.
I would rather not be discussing the likes of him. Not out loud, anyway. He has a way of knowing what's going on in this town. He can see things only a wizard could see.
Yes, or he knows how to use a telescope.
Yeah.
Besides, he's in charge around here. So long as we stay quiet and peaceful and do as we're asked, no harm will come to us.
Asked.
You should know that, my young man.
Oh, I do. More than you could know. What sort of curfews does Manannan have on the townspeople?
The usual. No noise after nightfall, bed before the 20th hour, no festivities at any time. Nothing unreasonable, I should think.
Especially when saying otherwise means...
Exactly.
Are you keeping well?
As well as can be expected. Aside from the shakes I get from time to time, the sores, the dizziness, the headaches, and the ringing in my ears, I'm doing quite well.
I'm glad to hear it.
Of course. I'm fine when I don't think on my past wives.
You have nothing further to discuss with the storekeep.
Wow, okay. So, despite all those nasty things, he's fine. Well, guys, thanks for watching. Gonna look around more of the town for as long as I can.
I've got some dusting to do. Let me know if you need anything.
I sure will, dude. Enjoy your dusting. See you next time. Bye-bye.